Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Time travel to the Viking era. Chapter 1. The Unforeseen Journey. Erik Larson, a historian passionate about Norse culture, found himself standing among the ancient ruins in the remote valleys of Norway. His fascination with the Vikings had brought him to this secluded site, known for its well-preserved rune stones and links to Norse mythology. As he traced the runes with his fingers, Erik mused over the stories they told, tales of warriors, explorers, and gods that had shaped the course of history. His reverie was broken by the sudden onset of a storm. Dark clouds rolled in, a rare occurrence for this time of year, and Erik decided to seek shelter. He took refuge in a small cave near the site, watching as the storm intensified. Lightning forked the sky, thunder boomed, and the wind howled like the ancient Valkyries of lore. It was in this dramatic setting that the unexpected happened. A bolt of lightning struck close to the entrance of the cave, and a surge of energy enveloped Erik. Blinding light filled his vision, and a sensation of being pulled through time and space overwhelmed him. When his senses finally settled, Erik found himself lying on the ground, the storm gone, replaced by a serene sky and the lush greenery of an untouched landscape. Confused and disoriented, Erik stood and surveyed his surroundings. It didn't take long for him to realize something astonishing. He was no longer in his own time. The landscape, the air, the very essence of the place felt ancient. As he ventured out of the cave, Erik encountered a group of people dressed in Viking garb, carrying tools and weapons of the era. His initial thought was that he had stumbled upon a historical reenactment, but the realism and the detail of their attire and tools quickly dispelled that notion. Using his knowledge of Old Norse, Erik cautiously approached the group, introducing himself as a traveler. The Vikings, suspicious at first, gradually warmed up to him, intrigued by his strange clothing and mannerisms. Erik learned he was in a small Norse village, a community of farmers and warriors. As he interacted with the villagers, he was struck by the authenticity of their lifestyle. It was a living embodiment of the history he had studied and loved. However, peace in the village was fleeting. Erik overheard discussions of a looming threat, a rival Viking clan planning an attack. This news was met with a mix of fear and resolve among the villagers, who began preparations to defend their homes. Erik's knowledge of history provided him with insights into Viking warfare and strategy, and he found himself drawn into the planning of the village's defense. He also heard murmurs of an ancient prophecy among the villagers, speaking of a stranger from another time who would appear in their hour of need. The prophecy intrigued Erik, but he remained focused on the immediate danger. He helped the villagers fortify their settlement and train in combat techniques. Despite the seriousness of the situation, Erik couldn't help but feel a thrill. He was living the history he had always studied from a distance. As days turned into nights, Erik adapted to the Viking way of life. He learned to handle a sword, to speak more fluently in Old Norse, and to understand the customs and beliefs of the people. The villagers, in turn, grew to respect Erik, valuing his knowledge and skills. One night, as Erik gazed at the stars, the same stars he knew from his time, he pondered the incredible turn his life had taken. He was a man caught between two worlds, belonging fully to neither, yet deeply connected to both. The night before the expected attack, Erik lay awake, contemplating the upcoming battle. He realized that his actions could alter the course of history, and the weight of that responsibility lay heavy on his shoulders. He was no longer just a historian, he had become a part of the very history he had dedicated his life to studying. As dawn broke, signaling the day of the battle, Erik donned Viking armor, feeling the weight of the chainmail and the solidity of the sword in his hand. He joined the villagers at the settlement's entrance, ready to face the unknown challenges of the day. The quiet of the morning was soon shattered by the sound of approaching warriors. The rival clan had arrived, their shouts and the clatter of weapons filling the air. Erik stood shoulder to shoulder with the Viking warriors, his heart racing with a mix of fear and adrenaline. The battle began with a clash of swords and shields. Erik, thrust into the heart of the conflict, fought with a determination fueled by his desire to protect his newfound companions. The fighting was intense and brutal, a stark contrast to the academic studies of his previous life. As Erik parried and struck, he couldn't help but feel a sense of surrealism. He was participating in a Viking battle, a scenario he had only ever read about in books and seen in movies. Yet here he was, in the midst of it all, fighting for his life and the lives of those around him. The battle raged on, and Erik found himself face to face with the rival clan's leader, a formidable warrior. Their swords clashed, and Erik was pushed to his limits. He recalled the techniques he had learned over the past days, using them to counter the warrior's attacks. Finally, with a well-placed strike, Erik disarmed his opponent, ending the immediate threat. The rival clan, seeing their leader defeated, retreated, leaving the village victorious but weary. As the villagers tended to their wounded and mourned their losses, Erik was hailed as a hero. The seeress of the village approached him, speaking of the prophecy and how he had fulfilled it. She spoke of the gods' watchful eyes and how Erik's arrival might have been more than mere chance. Erik listened, his mind a whirlwind of thoughts. He had traveled back in time, fought in a Viking battle, and become part of a prophecy. It was a lot to take in, and he wondered what his role in this era was meant to be. As the day came to an end, and the villagers celebrated their victory, Erik stood apart, looking up at the stars. He was a man out of time, living a life he had never imagined. His journey in the Viking era was just beginning, and he knew that more challenges and adventures awaited him. Chapter 2. In the Midst of Norse Gods. After the battle, the village was alive with a mix of relief and sorrow. Erik, hailed as a hero, found himself deeply entwined in the villagers' lives. but his mind was occupied with the seeress's words about the ancient prophecy and the gods. Intrigued and somewhat skeptical, Erik decided to explore these mystical elements further. The seeress, named Astrid, guided Erik on a journey to seek wisdom from the Norse gods. Their journey began with a trek to a sacred grove known as a place of spiritual power. There, under the ancient trees, Astrid performed a ritual, calling upon the gods to reveal their will. To Erik's astonishment, the ritual seemed to work. The air shimmered, and before him appeared a vision of Odin, the All-Father of the Norse gods. Odin, with his one eye and regal bearing, addressed Erik, speaking of a great upheaval in the realms of gods and men. He cryptically hinted that Erik had a role to play in the upcoming events. Shaken by the encounter, Erik continued his journey with Astrid to other legendary locations, each connected to the Norse pantheon. They traveled to a thundering waterfall, where they witnessed a vision of Thor, the god of thunder, wielding his mighty hammer Mjolnir. Thor's booming voice spoke of a battle that would shake the foundations of the world. At another site, a serene meadow, they encountered Freya, the goddess of love and war. Freya's presence was both comforting and daunting, and she spoke to Erik of the importance of balance and choice, hinting at the trials he would face. These encounters left Erik both awed and bewildered. He began to understand that his arrival in the Viking era was more than an accident. It was part of something larger, a tapestry woven by the hands of fate. Astrid explained that Erik's presence during the celestial event mentioned by Odin was crucial. This event, a rare alignment of the stars, was believed to affect the realms of both gods and men. The gods' messages, though enigmatic, suggested that Erik's actions could influence the outcome of this cosmic event. As they traveled back to the village, Erik's mind was filled with questions. How could he, a man out of time, have any impact on the world of the Norse gods? And what were these trials that Freya had mentioned? His return to the village coincided with the preparations for a traditional Norse festival. Erik decided to participate, hoping to find some clarity in the customs and beliefs of the people. The festival was a vibrant affair, with feasting, storytelling, and displays of strength and skill. During the festival, Erik's prowess in battle and his encounters with the gods became the stuff of legend among the villagers. He was no longer an outsider, he had become a part of their world, a bridge between the mortal and the divine. As the festival drew to a close, Erik was approached by the village chieftain, a wise and battle-hardened warrior named Ragnar. Ragnar had heard of Erik's encounters with the gods and sought his counsel. The chieftain was concerned about the future of his people, and the prophecy that Erik seemed to be a part of. Erik and Ragnar spent long hours discussing the Norse beliefs, the prophecy, and the possible outcomes of the celestial event. Ragnar, though a man of action, was open to the wisdom of the gods and the mysteries of fate. He pledged to support Erik in whatever trials lay ahead. The following days saw Erik integrating further into the village life. He trained with the warriors, learning the art of Viking combat and strategy. He also spent time with the village elders, absorbing their knowledge of Norse lore and history, but amidst this integration, Erik could not shake the feeling of foreboding. The celestial event was drawing near, and with it, the unknown trials. The gods' words echoed in his mind, a a constant reminder that his journey in the Viking era was far from over. As chapter concludes, Erik stands on the shores of the village, looking out at the sea. He is a man caught between worlds, holding the knowledge of the future and the wisdom of the past. The stars above begin to align, signaling the start of the celestial event, and with it, the beginning of Erik's greatest trial. Chapter 3. The Clash of Clans. As the celestial event drew closer, the atmosphere in the village grew tense. Erik Larson, now deeply immersed in the Viking world, found himself at the heart of the impending trials. The Norse gods' cryptic messages weighed heavily on him, and he knew that the alignment of the stars could bring about significant change, both in the realms of the gods and on Earth. The night of the celestial event, the village gathered to observe the sky. The stars began to align in a rare formation, creating an awe-inspiring spectacle. As the villagers watched, Erik felt a surge of energy, a confirmation that this moment was a turning point in his journey. At that moment, a longboat was spotted on the horizon. It was the rival clan, emboldened by the celestial event, launching a surprise attack. The village scrambled to arms, and Erik, alongside Ragnar and the village warriors, prepared to defend their home. The battle that ensued was unlike any Erik had experienced. The rival clan was led by a fierce chieftain, rumored to be favored by the gods. Erik and Ragnar led their warriors with courage and strategy, but the enemy's ferocity and numbers were overwhelming. In the midst of the battle, Erik found himself facing the rival chieftain. The duel was intense, a test of Erik's skills and resolve. As they fought, Erik realized that this confrontation was one of his trials foretold by the gods. He needed to prove his worth, not just as a warrior, but as a protector of the village's fate. Drawing on his knowledge of Viking combat and his own instincts, Erik managed to outmaneuver and defeat the rival chieftain. The victory turned the tide of the battle, and the rival clan was eventually repelled. In the aftermath, the village mourned its losses but celebrated its survival. Erik's role in the victory solidified his place in the village's lore. He had become more than a traveler. He was now a legend, a man who crossed time and faced the gods' trials. The celestial event's conclusion brought more than just the end of the battle. It ushered in a period of change. The gods, appeased by Erik's bravery and the village's resilience, granted a bountiful season and peaceful times. The prophecy, it seemed, had been fulfilled. However, Erik's journey was not over. In the days following the battle, he experienced vivid dreams, visions of other realms and times, hints that his role in the Viking era had broader implications. He consulted with Astrid, who interpreted these dreams as signs of Erik's continued connection to the gods and their plans for him. Astrid revealed to Erik that his journey through time might have larger purposes, perhaps even influencing the course of history beyond the Viking era. She spoke of other prophecies, other realms where Erik's presence could be crucial. Erik grappled with this revelation. His initial goal of returning to his time had grown into something much larger. He was no longer just a historian, he had become a part of the fabric of history itself. Determined to understand his role in these grand designs, Erik decided to embark on a new journey. With Ragnar's blessing and the village's support, he set out to explore other mystical sites and realms, seeking answers and understanding his place in the gods' plans. As he prepared to leave the village, Erik reflected on his experiences. He had arrived as an outsider, a man out of time, but had found a place among the Vikings. He had learned their ways, fought alongside them, and had become part of their story. With a mix of excitement and apprehension, Erik embarked on his new journey, traveling to distant lands and encountering different cultures. He faced challenges and trials, each shaping him and revealing more about his destiny. As chapter concludes, Erik stands on the edge of a new adventure, a journey that will take him across time and realms. He is a bridge between worlds, a man on a quest to uncover the mysteries of the gods and his role in the tapestry of history. Chapter 4. Return to the Future. Erik Larson's journey through the Viking era had transformed him. He was no longer just a historian studying the past, he had lived it. The battles he fought, the legends he unraveled, and the gods he encountered had left an indelible mark on his soul. After months of traveling across Norse lands, encountering different cultures and overcoming numerous trials, Erik felt a pull back to the site where his journey had begun. Guided by Astrid's visions and his own intuition, he returned to the sacred grove in Norway, the place of his initial transition through time. As he stood among the ancient trees, Erik reflected on his experiences. He had witnessed the lives of the Vikings, not as myths or stories in a book, but as real, complex individuals. He had seen their struggles, their joys, and their deeply rooted beliefs. The wisdom of the gods, the bravery of the warriors, and the mystical encounters had given him a new perspective on life and history. With a heavy heart, Erik prepared to leave the Viking era, a time that had become a part of him. Astrid, who had accompanied him, performed one last ritual. She spoke of the threads of fate, of Erik's unique place in the tapestry of time, and of the possibility that his journey might not end with his return. As the ritual reached its climax, Erik felt the now familiar sensation of being pulled through time. A blinding light enveloped him, and the sounds of the Viking world faded into silence. When Erik opened his eyes, he was back in modern Norway. The ancient site, once bustling with Viking activity, was now quiet, with only the wind whispering through the trees. He was home, but the world seemed different, altered by the way of his experiences. Erik struggled to readjust to modern life. The sights and sounds of the 21st century felt jarring after the rawness and vitality of the Viking Age. He found himself missing the simplicity and the directness of Viking life, the connection to the earth and the stars, and the sense of living alongside legends. Determined to share his experiences, Erik returned to his university. He documented his journey, his battles, and his encounters with the Norse gods. Though his tale seemed unbelievable, the depth of his knowledge and the details of his adventure captivated his colleagues and students. Erik's return sparked a renewed interest in Norse history and mythology. Scholars and historians approached him for insights, and his lectures became popular, drawing crowds eager to hear about his time-traveling adventure. But Erik's journey had also changed how he viewed history. It was no longer a distant, academic subject. It was alive, filled with real people with hopes and fears. he found himself advocating for a more empathetic and connected approach to studying the past. Despite his return to the modern world, Erik occasionally experienced vivid dreams of the Viking era. In these dreams, he revisited the places he had seen and the people he had met. Sometimes, he saw visions of other times and places, hinting that his journey through time might not be over. These dreams, along with Astrid's parting words, left Erik with a sense of unfinished business. He wondered if his travels through time had a larger purpose, one that he had yet to fully understand. One day, while researching in the university library, Erik came across an old manuscript. The text contained references to time travel and prophecies similar to what he had experienced. Intrigued, he began to research further, delving into legends and myths from different cultures. As he pieced together information from various sources, Erik realized that his journey might have been part of a larger pattern, a cycle of time travelers who had influenced history. The manuscript suggested that these travelers had roles to play in key events, shaping the course of human development. The discovery fueled Erik's curiosity and sense of adventure. He knew that his experiences in the Viking era were just the beginning. There were other times, other histories to explore, and perhaps other travelers like him. Erik began to prepare for the possibility of another journey through time. He studied various historical periods, learning languages, and understanding cultures. He also kept a close eye on the ancient site in Norway, the place that had been his gateway between worlds. Finally, Erik stands at the crossroads of time and history. He is a man transformed by his journey, a bridge between the past and the present. With the knowledge that his adventures through time might continue, he is ready to face whatever the future or the past holds.